Welcome to Racing Historic Vee. In this video, we'll show you the whole of race 5, which in my opinion was the best of the weekend. Plus, we'll have a walk around the pits, show you some of the cars and their starting positions. Starting from position 8 will be Glenn Briggs in his yellow 1983 Spectre, and his brother Dean will start from position 4 in the 1981 Spectre. Next we'll see Steve Batty in his 1976 Elfin, which will be ready after having a few problems on the weekend. Leading out the pack from pole will be Tony Painter in his 1971 Stag, and Ian Kutcher in the blue Renmax 1978 will start from position 14. Dave Harley will start from position 10 in the 1983 Spectre, and from position 7, Norm Johnson in the 1984 Spectre. You can see it here with the body panels off. Next you can see my hard-working crew on the 1977 Ranger, and we'll start from position 9. Beside me is Chris Rick's car, a 1971 Elfin Melmoth, and he'll start from position 11. Next is Damien Spink's 76 Nimbus, he'll start from position 13, and from position 12 under the cover is Greg Stott, 67 Mako. In the paddock area you'll find Don Grieveson, all the way from South Australia, in his blue and white 1984 Spectre. He starts from position 5. Pictured here without its red body panel is Steve Nilmore's 1982 Spectre, and he'll start from position 3. Unfortunately, missing from race 5 completely is Matthew Pearce in his 79 Remax. The car was on the trailer and on the way back home. Another dominating win by Tony Painter. I got second, but it was great racing. Big thanks to all the crew at Wakefield Park, the other competitors, and of course my crew, Catherine and Casey. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to the channel. And to help to promote the channel, please make a comment, press the like button, or share it with your friends.